Okay, good morning. It's the next weekend and we are going to put rain guards. So every time we go camping and we've been or are out kind of living and lucky for this season, when it's raining, we kind of, if you're in here, you get, it's really super stuffy because you can't really open the windows or anything while it's raining. So we end up parking underneath like a carport or a tent or easy up or something, just so that we can open the windows, which is not really the best use of space. And so I was looking around and I saw on YouTube there were these people putting rain guards on there, and I was like, why didn't I think of that sooner, you know? So we're gonna do those today. It's gonna be all things windows. We have some screens that we use, and we're gonna, once we get the rain guards on, we're gonna see if we have to remeasure the screens. We have like a roll of screens that we have down here, as well as a pile that are pre-cut that we've been using with magnets, and I'll show you that. And then we also got some window covers, which are by WeatherTech, that you can order, and they're a little bit expensive, and I am not thinking they're perfect. So let's do the WeatherTech windows thing first. There's Maven. Hi, Maven. Okay. So the WeatherTech covers look like this. This is the one for the front window, so it's super ginormous. And it's silver on the one side and black on the other. And the reason I don't love the black is because it's shiny. And so when you put it, if you, I don't know, I think I have a couple of them in the window here to start with already. And first of all, I don't know, hold on, I'm gonna flip this this around. In the window, you can see the WeatherTech thing, so that's gonna have to come off of there. There's like a little sticker that gives you a phone number and stuff to kind of help them. But what I don't know if you can see in the video is that you can also, if you're sort of looking at it with an angle or with the light, you can kind of see the shininess of this in the window. And I don't know if I get close to it, if that helps at all for you to tell, but I can see it. And the third thing I don't love completely, and I'll show you when we come in here, is that there's gonna be a little bit around the edges of some of these that still needs to be covered. So if I'm really trying to keep the light in to be stealthy, that's not gonna be a perfect science. We're gonna go in there and you'll see how much they really do offer, a lot of good. And so I'm gonna show you how much darkness they offer, and we'll show you how easy they go in. See, they just kind of squeeze in there, so when they fit, they're really great. And for these ones in the back, I'm just leaving them there because they don't hurt anything, and they're stealthy, and I can switch them around by putting them on the opposite windows. The only thing is, I can't do that with this back window because you can't tell it from right here, but maybe if I get underneath it, you can tell that is not perfectly lined up. So if you can't really turn it around because that light, that tail light, is in the middle. And so it's not actually ideal because you can only put the WeatherTech thing in one direction on the back. So I'm gonna end up getting a piece of cloth or something and sewing it to these so that I can take care of all of those problems. And I think just a dull matte black cloth will help with that problem. So just a piece of whatever kind of material I can find that's cheap. So let's do this. But I'm gonna put them in so I can show you kind of what they look like in. As you can see, there's plenty of daylight in here, and I'll actually climb into the car so that you can see the brightness within the car before putting these in and get a little bit of a before and after. So it's pretty bright. The sun is shining directly in right now. So we'll start with this as soon as Maven gets back to hold the camera. Okay, so this you can see has a little bit of edgery, and it may be that I'm just not shoving it in quite where it needs to go. Exactly, because this is supposed to be made for this car. So I'm gonna try a little harder here. Is that facing the right direction? Maybe I can slide this under. It'll do a little bit better. So this is allegedly made for the Chrysler Town and Country, which is this vehicle. But as you can see, there's a little bit of room here where you can see light coming through, and you'll see that better when we get those put in. Okay. Now, these are marked on the silver side, and it says driver's front, but we're not gonna put it on the driver's front because we're putting the black side out right now. And if we were gonna put it silver side out, that's the side we would put it on. So I'm gonna put it here, pop it in, and I can just pull this little tab to pop it out. And this one fits really well, but there is still a little corner of light right here. And I'm not sure if that would be the same if we put it on the driver's side. But for right now, there's just a little dot of light there. So, I like how easy these go in. I think that's awesome. The only one that we can't put backwards is this one. It has to be silver side up to fit because it's not central. The where the thing comes up is not center. So it's only made to go the one way. But you can see again, it's just really easy to pop in by myself. I don't need two people to get it to fit properly or tighten. And this fits around here, this one, really nicely. It kind of covers the whole piece. And so we've got, this one says it's the passenger rear, so we're gonna put it over there, and that will be the last one that we put in. And this one, I guess this one will be the last one we put in because you're gonna have to do it. So this one's gonna go in this way. And we can flip these so you can see what they'll look like with the silver side out as well, but we're gonna start with just darkening the space best we can for stealth. Now with this car, we also have this doodad so we can kind of help keep it up, but it's not really a problem at the moment. And then, do you want to come around, come in here and sit? This last one in. And it's stiff enough that it holds itself in, so you don't really have to work very hard at getting it to hold itself in. But again, if you want to come on in here, we can see how dark this all is. Okay, or I'll do that by myself. So you can still see that there's light in here, but I don't know if you can tell quite how much more darkness there is. Like, it's not black in here, but I certainly could sleep. So you can see, like, right there, when I make the cloth around this, that's one of the areas that I will affect. And, I'm gonna flip these around and see if the silver side out makes a difference as far as how much light actually comes into the vehicle. So we just switched this one around, the front one around to the silver side out. It was really hot to the touch after just a few minutes of having it with the black side out with the, in the direct sunlight. We switched it out and it's considerably cooler, so that definitely seems to matter. This one we still have the silver side in. So let's take a look at what the different windows look like out here. So on this one I have the silver side out and it's got the black tinted windows and you can really see it, but and then this is the black side out with the clear window and it looks kind of almost the same from this side. So it's kind of cool. Now if you see the black with the black side out, you almost can't see it at all with the exception of this WeatherTech sticker right there, and you'd have to be looking pretty close. So again, here you've got remove before driving. That's pretty visible. So if I was gonna black that out, I would have to hang my little cloth, that whatever, over the back of that. But it does keep a lot of the light out. And then same on this side.